بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم والحمد لله رب العالمين حمد الشاكرين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers, sisters, wherever you might be. Today or tonight, depending where you are, we are continuing, inshallah, this series of tafsir, which we call it Quran as revealed, in the sequence of revelation, where we started with Surah Al Falaq, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق نون والقلم وما يسطرون قل قم يا أيها المزمل قم الليل إلا قليلا يا أيها المدثر قم فأنذر الحمد لله رب العالمين تبت يد أبي لهب وتب. Until we reached last time, we talked about Surah Al-Fil, and then before that we talked about Surah Al-Kafirun, and before that we talked about Surah Al-Ma'un, أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين. So these are the surahs that we have done in the sequence, and tonight inshallah we are doing Surah Al-Falaq, which comes in the sequence after Surah Al-Fil, where Allah Azza wa Jalla, let me go back to the surah first, and then I will go into the deep discussions of these ayat. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. Say, O Muhammad, Allah Azza wa Jalla is teaching Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam something new. Say, I seek protection from you, رب الفلق. You are the رب of the morning, رب of the creation, رب of this emergence of new day. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ. I seek protection against the evils that have been created on this earth, that have emerged during this long life. There is some evil here, some shar. مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِلَى وَقَبَ. And I seek protection from the evil that comes creeping with a dark night. Once it becomes so dark, it becomes so, as we call it, very deep, deep, deep darkness. وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِلَى وَقَبْ وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدْ. And I also seek protection from you, my Rabb, from the those who use some type of magic, and they use try to blow smoke in certain threads in order to make some evil acts. وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِلَى حَسَدٍ. And from the evil of a person who envies others, the hasad, the envy, the bad envy, where you wish the something bad can happen to some other people. So this is the linguistic meaning, if you will. Those are the words, the meaning of the words and the verses. But then let's start taking them with deeper analysis. Now, in order to understand that, let's see where is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba at this point. Now remember that in the previous surah, Allah Azza wa Jal talked to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sahaba, and of course the people, about the event of the elephant. The elephant, the people from Abyssinia who came to destroy Al-Kaaba, and then Allah Azza wa Jal reports this story in the Quran for a very important significance here, that at some point when Allah Azza wa Jal decides that his words, his whatever he honors in this world, he will protect. And if Allah Azza wa Jal stands in the protection on the side of something that he's protecting, it will prevail. So the people who brought the army to destroy Al-Kaaba, they failed. Allah Azza wa Jal sent his own soldiers who happened to be some birds, and did whatever Allah Azza wa Jal wanted to do. And in the previous surahs, Allah Azza wa Jal talking to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, now there is a time to stand up and make this divide, if you will. This divide in a society, not based on color, not based on race, not based on have or have not wealth or poverty, but based on belief, based on the ideology, based on this type of appreciation of this universe being created by a God. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ All you who have decided to be kuffar, who have decided to take the path against Allah Azza wa Jal, who have decided to cover the truth, because al-kafir is the one who covers what should not be covered, which is the truth, the fact. Al-kafirun, there is a divide. And here it shows that the I would call it the struggle in the society of Mecca between al-haq, the truth that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was bringing from Allah Azza wa Jal, and the batil and the the evil, if you will, the evil that does not want this haq to prevail, the evil that wants this message of Islam to be destroyed. In fact, this was even revealed earlier in Surah Al Alaq, in the second part of the surah, which was revealed later, not in the same first time of the revelation, where it says, "Kalla inna al-insana la yatgha ar-ra'ahu istaghna inna ila rabbika ar-ruj'a ara'aita alladhi yanha 'abdan idha salla." Have you seen the one who stands up against someone who is praying to Allah Azza wa Jal, who is worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal, who is seeking the absolute acceptance from Allah Azza wa Jal, who is bowing down to the orders of Allah Azza wa Jal, who is taking Allah as the one and only one Rabb. And I mentioned time and time again that the main concern and the main divide between Muhammad, peace be upon him, and the kuffar, and the other part of the society, is that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with a message that declared that this Allah, this God, the one who created, the creator, is a Rabb. He's not only a creator, he's not only a God that you bow down to in a prayer, but he is a God that you listen to his orders. He's a God that you mold your behavior according to his instructions. And right from the very beginning, اقرأ باسم ربك. It is your Rabb, Allah Azza wa Jal, الذي خلق. He's the creator. The creator is your Rabb. واذكر اسم ربك. Remember the name of your Rabb. وتبتل إليه تبتيلا. Make sure that you worship him devoutly. Excuse me. That you devote your entire life sincerely to this Allah. In Surah Al-Muddathir, وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. In in all other surahs, in Surah Al-A'la, سَبِّحْ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ الْأَعْلَى, and so on. All of these coming time and time again, that immediately surfaces out that the main divide between Mecca and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not only the fact that Muhammad is saying Allah is a creator, or they know he's a creator. Because later on in other ayat, Allah says, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاءِ. You ask them, who created this whole universe and including the earth? They would say, Allah. لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. They would say, Allah. Who brings the water and the rain from the heaven, from the skies, from the clouds? They would say, Allah. Who brings the fruits and the trees from under the ground? They would say Allah. They have no problem with that. But then what's your problem? Why are you standing against this man? What is it in his message that raise your concern and make you fiercely stand against him? Label him as a person who wants to divide the society, a person who wants to break the unity of the society. As today, what is it that makes the US, Britain, Russia label some of the Muslims as terrorists, as fundamentalists, as backward, as someone who wants to change the structure of the world? What's wrong with changing a structure that is based on falsehood? There's nothing wrong with that. Everybody in the world wants a world that has justice. This is what Islam is about. But nevertheless, they don't like you. They don't want you to be around. Why? They don't want you to prevail. Why? Not because you are saying Allah, God, is the creator. After all of them are saying that. Even the ones who believe in the Trinity, they say, yeah, we do believe in the Trinity, but the Father, the God who is the Father, he's a creator. The Jews believe that there is a creator. The Hindus, Buddhists, all of them, they believe in a creator. But the way they behave vis-a-vis that creator is the point of concern and the point of issue. And that's what is causing the problem. Because today, just like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying, I am coming here to make sure that we worship Allah, the Rabb. We want to make Allah Azza wa Jal our only Rabb. اقرأ باسم ربك. Here, قل أعوذ برب الفلق. Again, repeating this, Rabb. This Rabb of Al-Falaq, that I am relying on. This Rabb of Al-Falaq, the Falaq now, what's the Falaq? Falaq, there are many meanings in Arabic for it, but the most popular meaning is that this is the rise of the morning. The rise of the morning. Al-Falaq, like in another ayah, Allah Azza wa Jal says, فالق الإصباح. He is the one who breaks in this morning, this light that comes in the morning. It's like it breaks into this universe. Allah is the one who does that. So he says, رب الفلق, which means he is the Rabb and the owner of this universe that we live in. And he is the one that we bow down to in our prayer, and we bow down to in our legislations, in the regulations, in the instructions, in the laws, in all that controls our behavior. We follow this Rabb. Now, what is it that is causing or bringing this issue that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam out of a sudden needs this absolute big protection? Seek your protection, ya Muhammad, from this God, the creator who creates al-Falaq, the one who stands behind this universe. After all, there is no question that the struggle in Mecca has come to a point where it is already obvious that the power of the kuffar is much, much, much more than the power of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, materialistically speaking, and his companions. His companions are hiding. They believe in Islam. They cannot declare Islam. If they do, and they happen to be weak, like Bilal radiallahu anh, like Yasser, like Ammar, like Sumayya, they will be beaten. They will be dragged into the desert. They will be tortured, just like today. When the intelligence of the world goes after someone who's a Muslim who's not threatening the lives of others, who actually threatening the corrupt system that utilizes or exploits the poverty and the weakness of the people, they go after you. And they have all this intelligence, and they have their cameras, their spying devices, spying people all over. They collect information, they do everything, and then they throw you to jail, they execute you, as they have done in Tashkent, in Samarkand, in Cairo, in Saudi Arabia, in Jordan, in the world. That's what they are doing. Where do you seek protection from? Who's going to protect you? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who's going to stand next to Muhammad? No one dares to stand up to Abu Jahl, the one who vowed that if Muhammad goes within the vicinity of the Kaaba, I will put my knees on his neck. I will kneel on his neck with my foot. And that's what we have seen in America, what they have done to the black person, George Floyd, if you've seen. But Abu Jahl did that for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not for racism, not for color, because he's a cousin of him, but because of this deen. Where is he going to seek the protection? Here Allah Azza wa Jal, after Surah Al-Fil, which we have read last time, when he said Allah Azza wa Jal stood on behalf of the Kaaba itself. Now he's telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I am here to protect you. Just ask for it. Ask for it. I am there. قل, say. And this is a new style in the Quran for the first time used. Later on, it was used many more times. قل, say. Later on, the next surah will be قل أعوذ برب الناس. Then قل هو الله أحد. قل إن الله مالك الملك. قل, say to them. And there are many, many ayahs that start with this قل. But this is the first time. قل, say. He's teaching him. And this is not only a word to utter with your tongue. It is something that you have to believe and understand and actually seek the protection. أعوذ برب الفلق. Say, I am seeking my protection. I'm looking for my protection. I am acquiring my protection, which gives me peace inside, tranquility inside, ability to continue from Rabb al-Falaq, from this Rabb, the one, the same Rabb that I believed in on the first day I was given the message. The same Rabb that Allah Azza wa Jal repeated time and time again and told me he is Rabb al-Mashriqi wa al-Maghrib, the Rabb of the East and the West. رب المشارق والمغارب, East horizons and West horizons. The رب الأعلى, the highest, the absolute. Seek protection from the one and only one. رب الفلق. Period. قل أعوذ برب الفلق. Now, where do I seek this protection? Against whom? Who is harming me? Who is going after me? Who is trying to nail me down? Who is trying to step on my neck? Who is trying to strip me out of my power? Who is trying to stop me from propagating this deen? شر ما خلق. Number one, the worst, from the worst. شر means the worst. Not the word evil is not too soft, but it's too general. But it says the worst of the ones who exist. So شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ. Of course, all of them are all the people are the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal after all. But some of them decided to go to the left side, to the other side. And they followed the devil, they followed the shaitan, they followed their own desires. They threw away Allah Azza wa Jal from their lives, from their minds, from their mentalities. And they decided to follow their own whims and their own desires, their wealth. And no matter in what way they will do it, that's what they are doing. These are شر ما خلق. شر ما خلق today, or at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the worst of the creation were Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Al-Akhnas bin Shuraiq, Al-Walid bin Al-Mughira, Wa'il bin Al-As, Al-As bin Wa'il. And the people knew them. Umayyah bin Khalaf, the one who used to drag Bilal to the desert. Abu Jahl, who killed Yasir and his wife Sumayya. These are شر من خلق. شر من خلق, the ones who used to have الربا. Allah Azza wa Jal talks about them in another ayah. وَمَا أَتَيْتُمْ الْرِبَى لِيَرْبُوَ فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ. The interest, they call it interest, it's riba. It's the usury. It's the worst type of financial gain. These are شر من خلق. These are the ones. Today, شر من خلق, the worst of creation today, you'll find them at الطاغوت, the oppressive regimes. The corrupt ones, they call them the deep state in America. They call them the bankers. They call them the wealth accumulators. Sometimes they call them the 1% who own more than 90% of what the people own. Today we see them. These are the ones who try to fight, make fights between themselves for one vaccine. Who's going to vaccinate whom and who's going to stop the others? Look at this war between Pfizer and AstraZeneca, the British one. These are the ones who are شر ما خلق. They don't care about the lives of the people. They don't care about my life, your life. They don't care about the message of justice. They don't care whether the justice prevails or not. They care about one and only one thing: my wealth, their wealth, how much more they want to gain. They are the ones who accumulate, as Allah Azza wa Jal talked about in Surah Al Fajr, which was we explained earlier before these surahs, where he says, "Kalla balla tukrimuna al-yatim, wa la tahadduna ala ta'am al-miskin, wa ta'kuluna al-turatha aklan lamma, wa tuhibbuna al-mala hubban jamma." You don't honor the orphan, you don't feed the miskin, you accumulate the wealth as it happens, and you have this extreme lust, not only love, but lust to the accumulation of wealth. These are شر من خلق. These are the ones that are opposing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah starts with them. He says, to protect yourself from these, Allah Azza wa Jal will protect you. Don't seek protection from others. No one can beat this up or overturn the game against the oppressors, like Fir'aun when Allah Azza wa Jal talks about Fir'aun later in Surah Al-Qasas, where he says, إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ. He has become so haughty, so big, so powerful. You can't deal with him. يَسْتَضْعِفُ طَائِفَ, oppresses some people. يُذَبِّحُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ, he slaughters the sons. وَيَسْتَحْيِ نِسَاءَهُمْ, he enslaves the woman. What else you want to do? He's the guy, the big guy. إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ, he's not only corrupt, he is causing corruption. He's creating corruption, he's breeding corruption. Exactly like what capitalism today. Exactly like what America is doing today. Exactly what Russia is doing today. Exactly what China, what Britain, what these so-called superpowers and their agents, their puppets, that's what they are doing. They are oppressing people. They are deviating people. يَسْتَضْعِفُ طَائِفَةً مِّنْهُمْ. Before that, جَعْلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيعًا. He breaks the unities between people. He breaks Libya into two or three, Sudan into two, Yemen into two and three, Lebanon into three or four, Syria. They are doing all types of games. This is exactly the same. This is what happened. Now, what do you do against them? Allah Azza wa Jalla tells Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will teach you something. You have to rely only on Allah. Don't hesitate. Don't deviate. Don't change. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. And that's the idea here, is don't be overwhelmed, because they can overwhelm you if you think you are alone. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. Say, أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. And this statement that you start with, which we do many times a day, and we are recommended to read these مُعَوَّذَات, these are not only for symbolic. If you are in the field, if you are in the field of the da'wah, if you are in the field of propagating Islam, if you are in the field of struggle with the kuffar, if you are in the field to make the word of Allah the supreme, if you are in this field of bringing this supreme justice to the world according to Islam, if you are in this field, of course, you will feel that you are almost lonely, that you are helpless, you are overwhelmed. Allah Azza wa Jalla telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't be overwhelmed. Say, I seek my protection. أعوذ برب الفلق. I am making this ta'wil, this isti'ana, this seeking the protection, this help. I am drawing help from. That's when I say أعوذ برب الفلق. I am drawing. You need to draw your energy from somewhere. You need to draw your support from somewhere. You need to rely on a source that's almost unlimited, that can overwhelm all of these powers which stand against you. Today, many people, they ask me the question, oh brother, you are talking, you want to bring Khilafah, Islamic State, a new world order. Are you crazy? Who can stand against America? Who can change a world order that has so many rules, so many holes, so many things that protect it? It has so many agents, so many intelligent agencies, so many satellites, so many things that can see the ant when it's crawling on the ground. What are you talking about, brother? Get serious. They overwhelm you. You have nothing. What is it that you are fighting with? Your tongue, your idea, your mind, your brain. Okay, you have good ideas. But brother, I'm sorry. You are not capable. You will not be capable of overcoming all these powers. I'll say wrong. Allah Azza wa Jal told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, during this whole sequence of revelation, through this sequence of revelations, he gave him words which are heavy. Allah knows what he gave Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are tough words. Inna sanulqi alayka qawlan thaqila. We will give you a word which is heavy. This is Islam. That's not a joke. You are standing up to the taghut, to the oppressor. You are standing up to Abu Jahl. You are standing up to Trump, to Putin, to Biden, to all of you. You are standing up to Mubarak, to Sisi, to this. You are standing up to all these evils. شر ما خلق. These are شر ما خلق. These are the ones who are شر, the worst and the worst and the worst of all. You can't imagine how bad they are. They are the worst. Allah says they are the worst. شر ما خلق. Allah is there to protect you. Meaning draw your energy from Allah. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. I draw my energy. I take my power. I accumulate my self-confidence from Allah Azza wa Jal, from my Rabb. from the Rabb, who is whose this title of being Rabb is the main reason why I am in this struggle. If Allah for me was only a God that I worship at night or at day, or I read, open my dua for in the same manner like they do it in churches or in mosques, then no problem. But if he's a Rabb, if he's my Rabb, then that very issue of Rabb, being a Rabb, is the issue, is what makes me on their list, on their hit list, if you will. And that's the main issue here. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ. The worst and the worst and the worst of the creation. That's number one. مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ. Number two, وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبَ. And from the evil that goes in the deep night when it becomes very dark. That's the linguistic translation. And that's what's being reported in the Tafseer. Ghasiq means the night, once it goes, drags on and on, it becomes very dark. What's wrong with a night that's dark? That's what night is supposed to be. Night, when there is no moon, no stars coming up, it's going to be dark. And this is the natural evolving of the day and night. But then there is yet something more, because Allah Azza wa Jal is not talking about the night itself. He says about the shar. There is a shar there. There is an evil that's happening. There is an evil that happens in the darkness. There is an evil that happens behind the closed door. There is a conspiracy that's being, or plots that are being plotted against Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He doesn't know. On the day, he goes out, he makes dawah. He talks to the people about Islam. At night, he goes and he goes to his wife, he prays, he raises his hands to Allah Azza wa Jal. But Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Al-Walid, Al-As bin Wa'il, Al-Akhnas bin Shuraiq, Umayyah bin Khalaf, they don't sleep. They go at night and they plan and they plot. They say, okay, let's see, what do we do with this man? One person says, you know, let him go, because if he prevails, then all of you will prevail as well. So what? Let him prevail. The other one says, no. How would it be possible that Muhammad prevail? He's from Bani Hashim. We are from Bani Makhzum. We are from different tribe. We will not allow him. A third person would say, well, if this man prevails, then all our wealth that we are accumulating becomes, there is someone has right to our wealth. Al-faqir wal-miskin. Like the surah which we talked about earlier. أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ فَذَلِكَ يُكَذِّبُ. He's denying this deen. Why? What's happening? يَدُعُ الْيَتِيمِ. He doesn't honor the orphan. وَلَا يُطْعِمُ وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَى طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ. He doesn't care about the miskin. يمنعون الماعون. They stop everything that's good. الماعون, everything that you can think of that's useful. They stop it. They block it. So this man is doing that for us. He wants us to stop all these practices that we have been accustomed to. This man or this Islam is going to close all these big banks with riba. How are we going to make lots of money? And the stock markets, oh God, these guys, they will not allow stock markets to work. How are we going to fool the people and allow the people to come and pour their money? And then at some point, they added their monies, and then we dump these prices down, and then they lose their money. This is a big game. This man or this Islam that's following that man, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is going to stop all of that. They do that, they plan that in the darkness. In the darkness means behind scenes. How am I going to protect myself? I don't have ways of stopping these plots. I don't even have ways to find these plots. Or even if I find them, how am I going to overcome them? And here Allah Azza wa Jal is directing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, says, don't worry. We know what's going behind these. When the night comes, when the darknesses take over, when this ظلمات, because Allah Azza wa Jal in time and time again, he says لِيُخْرِجَ النَّاسَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. He wants to drag the people out. He wants to bring the people, to deliver the people out of the darknesses, whether the darkness to the light, whether the darknesses, they make them so dark, so evil, or they plot the evil against what's good. I want you to come out from these darknesses. Come to the light. Come to the light. Enjoy the light. If you don't believe in it, at least you enjoy its benefit. If you don't, those people who did not believe in Islam and they lived under Islam, they benefited from Islam probably materialistically speaking more than the Muslims did. Because you bring them something, you struggle for it, you fight for it, you sacrifice your life so that everybody lives in justice, including the one who doesn't believe. Come out, man. Come out from the darknesses. Get out from the darknesses. Allah Azza wa Jalla wants you to get out from the darknesses. And while you are still doing the darknesses, while you are still within capitalism, within your democracy, within your nationalism, within your racism, within your poor versus rich, within all of these isms, while you are there and plotting to stop the rise of the light of Al Falaq, this, and when Allah Azza wa Jalla says Rabb Al Falaq is not just like that out of the blue, it's a picking of a word. No, Al Falaq, because Allah Azza wa Jalla is talking about Falaq, talking about the arrival of daylight, just like when he said Wal Fajri. Is swearing by Al-Fajr, the dawn. And here Al-Falaq, even beyond the dawn, that's the rise of the morning, the rise of the sun, the rise of the day, the rise of the light. Allah Azza wa Jal is the Rabb of the rise of the light. Seek protection from Him. Seek protection from the God, the Rabb, that who brings up the light from the people who plot in the darkness. The ones who use the darkness of the night. Now, of course, the issue is not the night here. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal does not use the word night. He says, ghasiqan idha waqab. Ghasiq means the one that builds darkness. The one that surrounds an entity with darkness. When darkness takes over, that's ghasiqan idha waqab, when darkness takes over. So between al-falaq, the rise of the morning and the rise of the light, that Allah Azza wa Jal is telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seek the protection from the one who creates and brings the light and brings the daylight against the one, against the shar, the evil, the worst of the one, the ones who are doing evil inside darkness. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. I am seeking the protection of my Rabb, the one who creates the light and brings the light from the worst of the people that exist. And I talked about these, I'm not repeating them again. And the evil that these sharru man khalaq, these worst of the creation, they use that ghasiq to plot against you. Seek protection from Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah is sufficient. Allah is more than sufficient. Allah is the one and only one who can be sufficient. And all of these forces, no one can penetrate their darknesses and see the plots and turn it against them, as it's said in another ayah, إِنَّهُمْ يَكِيدُونَ كَيْدًا وَأَكِيدُوا كَيْدًا فَمَهِّلِ الْكَافِرِينَ أَمِنُوا مُرْوَيْدًا. They are making plots, and I will turn their plots against them. وَإِذْ يَمْكُرُ بِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِيَقْتُلُوكَ أَوْ يُثْبِتُوكَ أَوْ يُخْرِجُوكَ. Those kuffar, they are making makr, thinking or plotting in the night, plotting in the darkness to make all types of evil against you, either kill you or evict you or force you to drop your message. But I am there for you. And here Allah Azza wa Jal says, say means say and believe and draw. Not only say, A'udhu. Draw from your Allah, from your Rabb. Act as Allah Azza wa Jal is your protector from all of this evil, from all of these worse of the worse of the people, worse of the creation, worse of the tyrants, of tyranny that exists here. And all the plots they do at night in the darkness. Then من شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد. Now here is Allah Azza wa Jal is bringing now a notion about certain type of people who will try to harm symbolically, psychologically, in any means. This was a means, نفاثات في العقد, some ladies that the people will go and seek their help, someone, and these are supposed to bring harm to someone else, to an opponent, do some types of magic, try some evil works. There are all types of things. Now, those who will plot against you, and those who will use and utilize all types of means, those who will utilize all types and all means and whatever they have, whether it's valid or invalid, you don't know about them, they go in the back doors, and that's exactly how it works when they say about النفاثاتي في العقد, the magics or magicians. People don't come in the open, like you don't go to a mall and you will find someone, oh, come and I will write you some a piece of thing or make some blow into a fire in order to kill someone or in order for someone to die or to lose his children or to have an accident. Or you don't do, you will go behind the closed doors. You go to and seek those type of activities. So here Allah Azza wa Jal is telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't worry, even if it goes that far, I am your Rabb, and seek protection from those. من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. This the last thing is about this envy. حاسد, many people, if you ask many people, they will say, oh, the hasad, if I make hasad, make an envy, then probably you are going to be hit, you are going to be to have an accident, or you'll be sick, or you'll lose a child, or look, we know that Allah Azza wa Jal had made for every effect a cause, a materialistic cause, and he made on top of all of this is the power of Allah Azza wa Jal to make it go through or not make it go through, period. No one is going to stand up somewhere and make an envy to Abu Talha to lose his, to have an accident in a street, and it will happen. That's not going to happen. But what is going to happen is that this entity that has this envy, that has this hatred, that has this wishful thinking that I should be hurt, that Allah Azza wa Jal says, seek protection from, not from his envy. He says, من شر حاسد, the evil of the حاسد, the evil of the one who does it, the one who has this mentality, this rotten mentality. Rotten mentality, the mentality of hatred, the mentality of wishing that you will lose, wishing you that you will never succeed. Succeed in what? Succeed in your ideas, in your thoughts, in your Islam, in propagating Islam. Here is the talk is about Islam. Here is not the talk about losing a car or losing a farm or losing a tree or losing a trade. Here, the issue of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not any of these. Here is the issue is someone, in fact, Allah Azza wa Jal talks about this issue of hasad. He says, وَدَّ كَثِيرٌ مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Many of those who are kuffar, who have accepted, who made kufr, لَوْ يَكُونُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ. They wish that they were, they accepted. However, they don't accept Islam or Iman. They don't want to be mu'min. حَسَدًا مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِهِمْ. حَسَدًا means because they are jealous. Hasad means they're jealous. They don't want you to prevail. They wish they were. I mean, many people deep inside, they say, man, this Islam is great. But if I accept Islam, that means these guys who believe in Islam and they want Islam to prevail, they will make it. I don't want them to make it. In fact, this is what Abu Jahl said. See, Abu Jahl, at one point of time, he was taking good about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And his folks, some of his friends, those who drank alcohol with him, they come up to him and said, Ya Abu al-Hakam, oh Abu al-Hakam, we heard you saying something good about Muhammad. Are you going to believe in him? Are you planning to change? He said, no way. Are you crazy? Do you think I will allow Muhammad, who is from the group of the family of Bani Hashim, to stand up and say, I am a prophet? And Bani Hashim, they will say, oh, we have a prophet among us, and Bani Makhzum don't. They were, Bani Hashim, they were rich. We were richer than them. They used to be generous and feed the pilgrimage to who come to make pilgrim to Mecca. And we did the same. They used to fight and make wars and steal the wealth of people. We did the same. But now they are claiming, someone claim, oh, we have a messenger from Allah Azza wa Jalla. We have a person who receives revelation from Allah. Where are we going to get a man like this? No way, I will not accept that. That's a hasad. That's jealousy. That he doesn't want you to prevail because he doesn't like what you are, he doesn't like you. He doesn't want you to prevail. In fact, the Quran talks about this issue, which says those when they debated among each others, the kuffar, in that same situation about Abu Jahl, they said, لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى رَجُلٍ مِنَ الْقَرْيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. Only if this Quran was revealed to another greater person. Muhammad is not great. Muhammad is not big. He's not a big shot. He's not Rockefeller. He's not Rothschild. He's not a Trumpist. He's not from the elites. He's a simple man. He used to shepherd the goats. لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى رَجُلٍ مِنَ الْقَرْيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. Only if this Quran was revealed to someone bigger, with more prestige, then we would follow him. But not this man, not this Muhammad. حَسَدًا مِنْ عَنْدِ أَنفُسِهِمْ. So here the Quran says, مِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ. You have to seek the protection against those hasidin. Because this hasid, this envy guy, this person with jealousy, he can harm you. Not his hasad. It's not that, as they call it, psychologically, I look at person and I envy him and I break his bone. Come on. There's nothing like that in Islam. Allah Azza wa Jal made for every material act, there is a physical cause for it. And as I said, on top of that, Allah Azza wa Jal allows whatever he wants to proceed from those with physical, is nothing that happens without a physical cause. There is a cause that Allah Azza wa Jal allows that cause to happen. But sitting somewhere with the hasad, with the envy, with the jealousy of Abu Jahl or Abu Lahab or anyone, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not going to fail. He's not going to be trapped. He's not going to lose his sight. But what makes him, could make him fail or get hurt, is because they will ask or they allow the wife of Abu Lahab to come and throw the garbage in front of his house. That is harm. Then Abu Jahl would say, if this man comes out to the vicinity of the Kaaba, I will nail him down. That's what the jealousy does. The jealousy can act on the person who carries that hatred from within to carry acts that are absolutely irregular, unacceptable, and could be harmful. You never know what this person can do. He can burn your house. Your house will not burn because he had a hasad. He had envy. So let's stop all of these, what we call them, mystic type of ideas that go around and people make money out of them. They'll say, there is hasad, or there is even a sihr. Someone did that for you, and you are going to collapse. The one who's making that will take a physical act against you. And he will take it at night, in darkness, in ghasiqin idha waqab. Behind the scenes, he can do that. And they pay money for it. So then the Quran now comes to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, says, you have to seek protection from the one who does that hasad, from the one who does that blowing in the fire, not from the blowing itself. من شر النفاثات, from the evil of the woman who does that act. Because in order to prove herself and to keep collecting money from the people, she has to do something. Otherwise, people will not believe in her. She has to do physical damage. So Allah Azza wa Jal is telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is telling us, you have to be always alert. And you have to draw energy from Allah Azza wa Jal. And you have to be always on the side of Rabb. And there are many entities that could work against you. Not necessarily they will, but they could. Depends on the situation. Like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the people worked against him. Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Al-Walid bin Mughira, they worked against him. And they did. And they wanted to nail him down. They did. And they did everything they could to bring him down and to stop him from propagating the da'wah. They did. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla tells Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in order to steadfast and to be on the right path and not to be worried about all of these, you have to seek protection only from your Rabb. From all of these, from the worst of the people who plot against you, from the worst of people and the worst of things that happen behind the scenes in the nights, from the worst of people who make envy and jealousy, and because of jealousy they can do anything you can think or not even think about, from all the people who try to use those behind the scene ladies, men, women, so-called magicians, so-called all types of tricky things, all of these that happen and you are unable to tackle them, I am doing it for you. Just rely on me. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. Read it, understand it, and draw energy and power from Allah. قُلْ أَعُوذُ, from whom? Rabb, the Rabb of Al-Falaq, the creator of this new day, the light. مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ, from the worst of the worst of the worst of all. Will try to stop you from doing what is right. And what's right here is Islam. And that's the message of Islam. That's what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was doing. You are not seeking the protection just like that. Oh, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بَرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. From what? What is it that you are doing that you want to seek protection against? You have to be doing something. You have to be in the field so that you understand this ayah, you understand its implication. رَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ, from the worst of the worst of the worst. Starting from the Russia, China, France, Britain, France, the ones that want to prevent women from hijab, prevent the halal food. Allah Azza wa Jal, we seek protection from Allah and we'll stand up against that tyranny and evil. We'll stand up against the tyranny and the evil of the United States, of Britain, of France, of Jordan, of Syria, of Lebanon, of Egypt, of Iraq, of Iran, of Yemen, of Pakistan, of India, all of this. They are big evils. I will seek protection against them from Allah Azza wa Jal. We'll continue to do our work. And no matter what the plots are being done in nights, ghasiqin, during the ghasiq idha waqab, and no matter what type of psychological, whatever impacts, and those people who are there using all their tools, and nafathat fil uqad is one of these tools. And whatever envy and jealousy they have against us, they can try whatever they want to do. I will stay with Allah Azza wa Jal. A'udhu bi Rabb al-Falaq. That's the surah, and this is a series of three next surahs. We'll talk next time about Surah An-Nas and Surah As-Samad. They come from a different angle. But this angle is the first one that Allah Azza wa Jal directs Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to and opens it up for him. This is a great impression on him. This is a great feeling for him and all the people who were oppressed and not necessarily hiding, but they were being chased in the society of Mecca, like Mus'ab bin Umayr, like Uthman bin Mad'un, like Abdullah bin Mas'ud, like Abdullah bin Rawaha, like Sumayya, like Yasir, like Bilal, like Ammar, like all of these. To them, this was a relief. It was time for them to get this big, big, big support from Allah Azza wa Jal. I will go to the questions now for the whatever minutes I still have. There is a question that says, please provide some examples from Quran which give you courage and motivation to continue. Well, this question comes right on this surah. Remember what I mentioned, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until that day, his message has not prevailed all over, correct? He was still in the struggle. He even still has not gone to Al-Ta'if to look for protection there. And he was being chased, if you will, wherever he goes. And they talk about him, and they block the people from talking to him, and they torture whoever believes in him. And he needs this support. So this comes, this surah, you are asking this question. This is one of the surahs that Allah Azza wa Jal provided to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The surah before that, Al-Fil, it was a general one that don't worry, Allah Azza wa Jal did something big and great to protect Al-Kaaba. And you are even worth more than Al-Kaaba, because this is the message that should emanate and should come as a light from the Kaaba. So Allah Azza wa Jal is behind this message. And in another place, Allah Azza wa Jal, he talked to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially right in the very first surah, although this the second part of the surah, where Allah talks about when Abu Jahl being a taghiya, kalla inna insana la yatgha arraahu istaghna. Until to the end, Allah Azza wa Jal says, falyad'u nadiya. Let him call whomever he wants. سَنَدْعُ الزَّبَانِيَةِ. We will call our own soldiers who will beat him up to this man who is standing against Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah Azza wa Jal, furthermore, he says, لَنَسْفَعًا بِالنَّاصِيَةِ. We will hit him right on his forehead. That is a relief. That's a support. Right from the very beginning, we still have not reached the place where Allah Azza wa Jal says, I'm sending soldiers to fight with you, like in Surah Badr. That was later. But here he's still in the middle of the struggle. Those are the type of ayat that we're coming in as it goes. In Surah Al-Fajr, Allah Azza wa Jal provided that in a different meaning. He talked about the tyranny in general. والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر until he says ألم ترى كيف فعل ربك بعاد. Didn't you see what I have done with the people of عاد, إرم ذات العماد التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد. Those were huge, great people. They thought no one was bigger or greater or bigger than them, like what Biden was saying the other day. I vow while I'm in office I will make the United States the most powerful nation in the world. I will not let it go down. That's what the people of عاد used to say. We are the greatest, we are the biggest. No one can deal with us. Allah Azza wa Jal told the Sahaba, didn't you, and Muhammad, didn't you see what I have done to these people? I've taken them away. They are done, they are gone. Nobody talks about them. Nobody knows where they are now in history. Wa Thamud, not only Ad, and then Thamud. Not only Thamud, but Fir'aun also. Not only Fir'aun. But anyone who comes after them, I will be bil mirsad. I will be there watching and I will do the same thing for him. That was an ayah in supporting the believers in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and giving them the comfort that I am there with you. But stay on the right path. That's the idea. Stay. Don't deviate. Don't say it's too long. Don't say it's too heavy. Don't say it is giving my chest hardship in my chest. Harajan fi sadri. Don't do that. Just stick to what you are doing. That is the ultimate, one of the best, one of the best surahs revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during that path of da'wah. No wonder that it is recommended to read this surah with the surah An-Nas and surah As-Samad right after every prayer. Read them. Some places say one time, some three times. Keep it there. But trust me, if you are not in the process of doing something big that warrants someone to oppose you and stop you and cause evil to you, you will not get the gist of this surah. You have to live the condition, live the environment in which it was revealed, live the environment which this surah came to address, and you will see the impact, you will feel it, and you will know how powerful, how great, how strong this surah is, and it was timely then, and it's timely today. Today, it is absolutely timing, especially when all the forces of evil, they differ on all issues. Look, America, Russia, Britain, France, China, they differ. They differ on trade, they differ on nuclear weapons, they differ on ballistic missiles, they differ on vaccines, they differ on corona, they differ on everything. The only thing they don't differ on is to fight and stop the rise of Islam, the rise of Al Falaq, the breaking of this light of Islam. They agree on this. They don't differ on that. This is sharru ma khalaq. If you live this environment and you feel it and you understand it, then you know that I need my Rabb to be on my side. I need to draw my energy from my Rabb. Jazakum Allahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'll stop right here and I will see you inshallah in 2 weeks. It will be Ramadan then, probably, or just before Ramadan, where we'll talk about Surah An-Nas. قل أعوذ برب الناس إن شاء الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.